budget was placed 3 days ago, and this union budget is a major exercise in deception. It's the first time we have a budget in which big announcements are made without any funds allocated for implementation. Finance Minister has announced that farmers will get 1.5 times the cost of production as the price for the crops. That is the Swaminathan Commission recommendation. Cost of production plus 50% more will be the minimum support price for farmers. But how to implement it? They have not given any allocation for getting this implemented. Similarly, it talks about health for 550 crore people, 5 lakhs per year coverage in insurance. It's a big, they claim this will be the biggest health scheme in the world. But if you look at the budget allocation figures, only 2000 crores is allocated for this. And the minimum cost will be 1 lakh crore, according to health experts. Not only that, this is through insurance for private hospitals. So this will only fill the pockets of the insurance companies and private hospitals. This is not helping the national public health system. Third point is, as far as petrol and diesel prices are concerned, we all know that since the Modi government came into office, excise duties on petrol and diesel were increased 9 times. And now the cost of oil, which we are importing, international prices are going up again. And here also, the price of diesel and petrol is going up. So the government has announced 2 rupees reduction in excise duty for petrol and diesel. But on the other hand, they have increased the cess on highways and infrastructure by 2%. So they have, one hand they have reduced 2%, and on the other hand they have again increased by 2% the cess which will be there. So petrol and diesel prices will continue to increase. So that is why I said that this budget is a very deceptive budget, and it will increase the burdens on the people. That's all I have to say.
Any questions?
Sir, we expect before elections next
month. Sorry?
Can we expect early elections?
Early election.
Central.
Well, I don't know. I don't know whether there will be early election, but there will be a number of assembly elections, definitely, as you know, this year. And the first election is going to be held in Tripura on the 18th of February, and another 6-7 elections are due in this year. Whether the government wants to advance the Lok Sabha election, we don't know.
But so what is the CPM stand in combined elections, which was saying by Modi?
Jamili election.
We are saying that this will be wrong, forcibly changing the tenure of Assembly and Parliament is anti-democratic. It is against the spirit of the Constitution. That is, they'll have to either reduce the life of some legislatures or extend the life of some assemblies to make it become simultaneous. All sorts of proposals are there. If you reduce the term of the legislature, governor's role will be there for the rest of the tenure. Even in the Lok Sabha, there is a proposal that if the government falls, if there's no majority, then president will run the have a council of ministers and run the government. That means the 5-year term cannot be changed. Suppose the government is defeated on the floor of the house, it will resign. Normally there will be dissolution of Lok Sabha and fresh election. Proposal is no, 5 years must continue. So president will rule the country, and in some states governors will rule the country. This is completely undemocratic, and this will go against the basic structure of the constitution. So our party is totally opposed to artificially bringing simultaneous elections. People have the right, legislators have the right, they may decide to vote a government out at any time. Then the only way is to have a midterm election, both at the central level, Lok Sabha level, and in the state assemblies. To demand or to say that 5-year term must be fixed and no midterm dissolution of assembly should be there, according to us, is anti-democratic. Thank you. Anything else?
Can CPM party is
joining any front, sir?
Sir, in future, CPM government will form nationwide.
You see, we are not talking about elections. Our alliance and front will be an alternative to the existing policies of the bourgeois parties, what we call a left and democratic alliance and front. That front will consist of working class, farmers, agricultural workers, middle classes, etc. That's a type of alliance or front we are trying to form. That is our basic goal. In the meantime, when elections come, we shall work out appropriate electoral tactics. In the present political situation in the country, our main aim will be to defeat the BJP and oust the Modi government. How to do that? At the time of elections, we'll work out appropriate election tactics.
What is your opinion on BLF, Bahujan Left Front in Telangana?
Well,
we
have announced it because we want to present an alternative to the people. We hope more forces will join the BLF. It has just started, and we hope that this will emerge as an alternative pole in Telangana politics.
In future, nationwide, we expect that BLF Light Front.
Similar alliances will be there depending on the situation in different states. It can't be the same pattern, but similar will be there. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.